Have you ever stared at a patch of dead, compacted soil in your garden and felt completely overwhelmed? Maybe it's that stubborn corner where nothing seems to grow, or perhaps you've inherited a neglected yard that looks more like concrete than earth. Well, take a deep breath and relax, because I'm about to share the laziest, most effective method for bringing dead soil back to life. And the best part is, you only need to do it once. This isn't about complicated soil amendments or expensive fertilizers. Instead, we're going to work with nature's own time-tested system, the forest floor method. Think about it. No one fertilizes the forest, yet it thrives year after year with rich, dark soil teeming with life. We're simply going to recreate that magic in your own backyard, using materials you can easily find or even have lying around already. The cardboard foundation, your soil's best friend. The first step in this lazy gardener's approach is laying down cardboard directly over your problem area. Don't worry about removing weeds or grass. In fact, leave everything exactly as it is. The cardboard will smother unwanted vegetation while slowly breaking down to feed soil organisms. Choose large pieces of corrugated cardboard, removing any tape or staples but leaving the cardboard plain and unbleached if possible. Overlap the edges by at least 6 inches to prevent weeds from sneaking through gaps. This cardboard layer serves multiple purposes. It blocks weeds, retains moisture, provides carbon for decomposition, and creates pathways for earthworms to travel beneath. As the cardboard decomposes over the next 6 to 12 months, it will have loosened the compacted soil underneath while providing food for beneficial microorganisms. The grass and weeds beneath will decompose, adding their nutrients back into the soil naturally. This is permaculture at its finest, working with natural processes rather than against them. Once your cardboard foundation is in place, it's time to build the organic layers that will transform your dead soil into a thriving ecosystem. Start with dry leaves, nature's perfect mulch. Rake them from your yard, ask neighbors for theirs, or contact your local municipality, as many collect leaves in the fall and give them away free. Apply a thick layer of leaves about 4 to 6 inches deep directly over the cardboard. Don't worry about shredding them first. Whole leaves actually work better for this method because they create air pockets that prevent matting and allow water and air to penetrate. Next comes the straw layer, so just add a couple of inches of straw on top of the leaves. This really helps hold everything in place while you're adding different organic materials to your, well, decomposition cocktail. Straw actually breaks down more slowly than leaves, providing long-term structure to your mulch layer while also feeding different types of soil organisms. The key here is layering different materials with varying decomposition rates. This creates a continuous feeding system for your soil organisms. Some materials provide quick energy, while others offer sustained nutrition over months. Now comes the crucial step that, honestly, a lot of gardeners overlook: proper moisture management. Your layered system needs to be consistently moist but not waterlogged to support the army of decomposers that will transform these materials into rich soil. Alright, so give your entire layered area a thorough soaking with a gentle spray from your hose. The water should really penetrate through all the layers and reach the cardboard beneath. You'll know you have enough moisture when you can squeeze a handful of the material and a few drops of water come out, but it doesn't drip steadily. During the first few weeks, you want to check your moisture levels regularly. The decomposition process, you know, requires consistent moisture, much like a compost pile. However, once the system is established and the materials begin breaking down, the layers will naturally retain moisture much better than bare soil ever could. While your layered system will eventually decompose on its own, adding red wiggler worms can dramatically speed up the process. These aren't your regular garden earthworms. Red wigglers are composting champions that can process organic matter incredibly quickly while producing nutrient-rich worm castings. You can, purchase red wigglers from gardening centers, online suppliers, or even local fishing shops. Introduce them after your layers have been in place for, you know, a week or two and have settled into their new environment. Simply lift sections of your mulch and place small groups of worms throughout the area. Red wigglers will work tirelessly beneath your layers, breaking down organic matter and mixing it with the soil below. Their tunneling action also helps break up compacted soil naturally, improving drainage and root penetration. Within just a few months, you'll notice dark, rich castings appearing throughout your mulch, a sure sign that your soil revival is working beautifully. The hardest part of this method is simply waiting and trusting the process. Unlike quick fixes that require constant attention, this approach works slowly and steadily. Over the first few months, you'll notice the material settling and beginning to decompose. The sharp edges of leaves will soften and the overall height of your mulch will decrease as materials break down. By the 6-month mark, you should be able to dig down and find that the cardboard is beginning to disintegrate and the soil beneath is noticeably darker and more crumbly. After a full year, most of the original materials will have transformed into rich, dark soil amendment that's been naturally incorporated into your existing soil. The beauty of this system is that it continues working even after the initial materials have decomposed. The improved soil structure, increased organic matter, and thriving microbial community create conditions that support healthy plant growth for years to come. Once your soil has been revived through this natural process, maintaining its health becomes remarkably simple. The key is never leaving your soil bare again. Continue adding organic materials as they become available. Fallen leaves in autumn, grass clippings in summer, kitchen scraps occasionally. Your renewed soil will now have the biological activity and structure to process new organic matter efficiently. The earthworms and microorganisms that have taken up residence will continue their work, ensuring your soil stays healthy and productive with minimal effort from you. This method transforms gardening from a constant battle against nature into a partnership with natural processes. Instead of fighting weeds, compaction, and poor soil, you're working with the same systems that have created rich soil in forests for millions of years. There you have it, the ultimate lazy gardener's method for bringing dead soil back to life. This simple approach harnesses nature's own soil-building processes, requiring just one initial setup and then letting time and natural decomposition do the heavy lifting. Your soil will thank you, your plants will thrive, and you'll have more time to actually enjoy your garden rather than constantly working in it. If this method resonates with your gardening philosophy, make sure to subscribe to Hydrohaven for more practical, low-maintenance gardening solutions. Share this video with fellow gardeners who might be struggling with poor soil. They'll appreciate learning about this game-changing approach. And don't forget to comment below with your own lazy soil revival tips. We'd love to hear what's worked in your garden and build a community of gardeners who believe in working smarter, not harder.